In this simulation, we're going to be measuring the pressure change given off by the reaction of a metal inside an acid. So as we react the metal with the acid, hydrogen gas will be given off. Now that hydrogen gas is going to be captured within a flask, and so we'll be measuring the pressure difference as that happens. So this is an exact copy of what you'll be doing in the real lab. And it's meant to get you familiar with most of the procedure of how to do this. So a couple of recommended points. We almost always want to be doing these simulations in full screen mode. Okay, so we're going to do that by clicking up in the top right-hand corner or tapping in the top right-hand corner for a touchscreen device. Now, if you are on a touchscreen device, generally speaking, the smaller the screen, the poorer the experience. It's much more convenient to interact with these types of models on a bit of a larger screen. If you want to move throughout the lab, you're going to scroll. Scrolling forward allows you to zoom in on particular objects. Scrolling backward allows you to zoom out and get a broader view of the lab. You can also click and drag to move your perspective across the lab. So this is like panning through the lab. And so this will allow you to explore and see all of the different items that you've got to interact with. So for this lab, we've got magnesium, zinc, and an alloy. This follows exactly from your pre-lab and your laboratory manual. So be sure to refer to that in terms of all the data treatment and the sorts of procedures that you're supposed to follow. But here in the simulation, we've got a couple of helpful points. So on the bottom, we've got our menu of operations that we can perform at any particular time. And over here on the left, we've got our live updating list of to-dos, if you will. So this is how we are going to actually complete this simulation. So I just want to walk you through that for this simulation so that you have a sense of how this works. It is a click and point and click interface. So as opposed to trying to drag objects around, what you're going to be doing is clicking on them. When you can interact with an object, it'll be identified by the blue floating halo around it. So I can clearly see that I can interact with this wayboat. And you'll notice that the labels for these items are populated at the top right. So you can see this is indeed called a wayboat. And so my instructions here say place the wayboat on the balance. So I'll click that wayboat. The halo multiplies. That tells me that it's been selected. And you'll see an orange halo in places where you can move that object. So if we put it onto the balance, we see what its mass is, 0.481 grams. Tearing the balance is the same as pressing the zero button. So what it's doing is it's considering the mass of this wayboat as zero. Now, we're going to select one of the bottles. And so let's select magnesium in this particular case. And notice that the wayboat becomes active when I select the magnesium. That tells me that that's the item that I can use to interact with the magnesium. So now I can see my piece of magnesium is on that wayboat and I see the mass. And so interestingly, this is a unique mass. This is a mass that's unique to me, and each of you will have your own unique mass as well. And so each of your experiments is very unique in that way. If I take this particular sample, I can put it over into my Erlenmeyer flask, and there it is. Now it's pretty hard to see from this angle. I can zoom in or I can use a little feature called a double click. So if I double click onto the flask, it instantly zooms in for me and I can see my little piece of magnesium there. The stopper to my flask and the hose is behind it. But there's the chunk of magnesium that I'm going to react with the acid. Now, whenever I'm zoomed in like this, I can always zoom out by hitting the enter key as it indicates down here on the bottom. So tapping the enter key will bring me back out. Likewise, if I'm clicked in, if you're using a touchscreen device, this zoom out button up here at the top will take you back out as well. So completing the experiment, it says I have to choose the correct acid. So I have to choose the acid that I want to react with magnesium. That's going to be my 1 molar HCl. Again, so I activate it, and you'll notice that this beaker becomes responsive over here. And this is because when we're dispensing chemicals in the lab, we never dispense directly from the original bottle. We put into a beaker before we measure out the volume we need. Now, most of the measurements done in these simulations are with arrow keys. So we can pour the liquid essentially by pressing or tapping our up key. Or, as you can see on the screen, there is an up button over here if you're using a tap or touchscreen device. we can fill this up to approximately 10 mils. There we go. Now, when we do that, our next step is populated there for us. We're just going to hit the enter key again because we're in the zoomed in state. And now what I'm going to want to do is attach this pressure sensor in behind here to the top of the flask. Okay, so now I've got my flask sealed and I've got it attached to a pressure sensor. And here is my output right here. So this is effectively atmospheric pressure for us. And what we're going to do is start collecting data. Our step here says click the table button. That's this one. And this is going to be our data logger for the experience. I can push the record data button anytime I want. And it's going to simulate the collection of data at 1 second intervals. But one thing to keep in mind is that the simulation is accelerated because we don't necessarily want to sit and wait. That's something we'll reserve for the real lab. So in this case, we've got our magnesium down at the bottom. Our pressure is equilibrated, isn't changing at all. So we're ready to start the reaction. It says when the pressure reading is stable, add the acid from the graduated cylinder. So we've already measured out our acid. We click it, we can either put it back into our container or go ahead and put it in the Erlenmeyer. Let's do that and we'll start this reaction. As you zoom in, you can see the magnesium slowly bubbling away and dissolving. This is very much like what it would look like in reality. And it's just about gone. And I can see as it dissipates, I'll notice up in my top right hand or top left hand side here, the pressure is actually increasing. Okay, so I've let the pressure equilibrate. It's certainly gone up by quite a bit. And my steps here say that once the pressure stabilizes, we can hit the stop recording button. There we go. And then we can export this data to really any spreadsheet program, something like Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets. We'll open this up fine and you can look through your data and do the proper analysis that you're going to want to do. Next, what we're going to do is we need to measure the volume of this flask. And the reason we need to measure the volume of this flask is because that is the volume that the hydrogen gas is occupying, right? So if we're going to use the ideal gas law, we need to know what that volume is. The graduations on the side here won't help. So what we're going to do is we're going to mark a line on the side of the flask. You can see that right there, that white line that we just marked by long clicking on the Erlenmeyer and choosing that from the options. So that is indicating to us where the stopper ends at the neck of the Erlenmeyer flask. And now what we're going to do is pull that stopper out. We're going to clean the flask again by long clicking on the Erlenmeyer, pressing the clean button. And what we're going to do is we're going to fill this Erlenmeyer with water right to that line, and we're going to measure the mass of the water because we know the density of water. The density of water at this temperature in this simulation is 1 gram per milliliter. So that means that for every gram of mass we measure in this Erlenmeyer flask, that's associated with a single milliliter of volume. So here's how we're going to do that. Our balance is right over here. Let's zero that balance one more time. I'm going to put the Erlenmeyer flask on the balance and we're going to get a mass. So again, this is a mass that will be unique to each and every one of you, but there it is. So we've got the mass of our Erlenmeyer. We can note that down if we like. Alternatively, we can zero it. And so this empty Erlenmeyer flask is considered zero on this balance right now. Now what we'll do is fill the flask with water. Again, using the up arrow or the up button here on the screen for those of you with a touchscreen device, we can slowly but surely fill up that Erlenmeyer. And the goal here is to get it right to that white line because we want to measure that precise volume. So as I get it up, I'm going to stop right about there. So I'll hit the enter key now to zoom back out. And now that I've got my Erlenmeyer filled with water, I'll bring it over to the balance and get the difference. So here is the difference in mass associated with filling the Erlenmeyer. So from this, we can work out the volume that's inside that Erlenmeyer flask. So now you know the volume that's inside the Erlenmeyer flask. And you also know the pressure change that you observed here as a result of the reaction that produced hydrogen. From that information, you can get to the moles of hydrogen that you produced. And you can get all the information you need through the ideal gas law and the procedures that are in your lab manual. Same procedure exactly for our alloy. The math will be a little bit different, but the sim will work exactly the same way. So you can either go ahead and press the reset button up here at the top to rerun it with a different sample, or you can just come right out of the simulation and try it again later.